So hello guys, welcome to AirTap, and guys, welcome to your another important lecture for the most important PIB news that we have seen in news from 28th to 31st of July. And if I talk about these news are equally important for your all the examinations of RBI, SEBI and NABARD. So now guys, without wasting any time, let's start with the first section, that is the questions that are relevant only for your phase 1 examination. The first question is, guys, recently the Global Tiger Day has been celebrated. We know it has been celebrated on 29th of July. Now this year the question I'm asking you is, on the Global Tiger Day, which among the following tiger reserve has basically played the host for the National Global Tiger Day celebration? Remember this thing, it is nothing that National Global Tiger Day, something else. In nation, that is in India, which tiger reserve has basically, where this Global Tiger Day has been celebrated? The question is on that specific line, and the answer for that is the Doba Tiger Reserve in Maharashtra has served as basically has been the host for the National Global Tiger Day celebration this year. Now your one homework will be, what you have to do is look at all these tiger reserves and try to see in which city, in which state they are. We know Manas is Assam, Panch is Madhya Pradesh, Ramgarh, which are very important, is Rajasthan. Satyamangalam, you have to tell me in the comment box where Satyamangalam Tiger Reserve is located. Next question, when I talk about Tiger's Day, so Tiger Reserve, if I talk about, so the next question I am asking you is, how many Tiger Reserves are there in India? This is a very important question because recently a Tiger Reserve has been added. So you have to tell me which Tiger Reserve has been added. So guys, this was somewhere news 2 to 3 months back that recently the 52nd Tiger Reserve of India has been created, and the Tiger Reserve was, that is the Ramgarh Vishdhari Sanctuary or Ramgarh Vishdhari Tiger Reserve in Rajasthan is the latest tiger reserve, that is the 52nd tiger reserve of India. That is again very very important for examination. So you might be feeling, sir, question, if a question comes on Ramgarh Vishdhari Wildlife Sanctuary, you might be feeling, sir, this is a question that has been asked 6 to 7 months back. But guys, that is not the reason. The reason here is because it is being seen in news, so there is a higher probability that the question can be asked on this specific sanctuary also. Now coming to the news, guys, if I talk about, so yes, the Doba Tiger Reserve in Maharashtra was basically has played the host for the National Global Tiger Day celebration on national host. It was celebrated, as I have discussed, the day is celebrated on 29th of July. If I talk about this year, guys, so this year there is no specific theme. Yes, there is no specific theme that has been announced yet. So you might be wondering a lot of things, but guys, still I have looked at the original website also, I could not find, but I have researched a lot. So one thing I have found is there is no specific tiger theme for this year for the Global Tiger Day. Now the other important thing, if I talk about, so here when the minister was attending this specific conference, he has briefed that India total has 52 tiger reserves, and 52nd I have discussed with you, that is the Ramgarh Vishdhari Sanctuary in Rajasthan. Now guys, if I talk about, so here when I talk about tiger reserves, the most important, what are the initiatives government has taken for the conservation of tiger? Two important things we have to discuss is Project Tiger and AmSlimes. So when I talk about Project Tiger, guys, important to remember, we know it is for the conservation of tigers and it was launched in 1973. When I talk about AmSlimes, guys, it is basically the initiative is launched, okay, to conserve tigers, and here basically a stripe has been created. Ek simple bhasha mein bole, ek stripe laga di jati so that a tracking of a tiger could be done here. This is the name here, Monitoring System for Tiger Intensive Protection and Ecological Status, that is AmSlimes. This is again an important initiative that we need to remember from the perspective of tiger conservation in India. Now coming to the next question, guys, third question, again an award has been presented, and awards are always important for examination. So recently Vice President has presented this National Literary Award, that is the Dr. C. Narayan Reddy National Literary Award, to Dr. Pratibha Ray. So this is important for us from the current affairs perspective. But now what the examiners are doing in the recent examination trends that we have seen is, they are not just asking you the basic question, they are going really really in depth there. So here the question I am asking you is, she is a renowned poet, she is a renowned writer. You have to tell me, she is writing in which of the following language of India? And the answer is, she is famous writer of Odia. She is a famous writer in the Odia languages. If I talk about her, so if I talk about the news on 29th of July, this was seen in news that Vice President has given this Dr. C. Narayan Reddy Award to Dr. Pratibha Ray, who is the eminent Odia writer. Now, if I talk to our Dr. Pratibha Ray, guys, two important things that we need to remember about her is she has received the Jnanpith Award in 2011, Padam Shri in 2007, and Padam Bhushan in 2022. So, now why I am telling you this thing is if an examiner is going up to an extreme level in which I can say ki aap bahut hi mushkil question banate, you will not be able to attempt, then only these kind of things will be asked. That she has received an award, she's a prominent, she's an eminent Odia writer, she has won which of the following award recently? So she has won the Padma Bhushan in 2022. That is important for us. That is really, really important for us. Now coming to this Dr. C. Narayan Reddy, what's so important is Dr. C. Narayan Reddy, he's a famous Telugu writer. So remember this thing, C. Narayan Reddy sir was a Telugu writer, but the award is not given for the Telugu writer. Award is basically being presented to the Odia writer. And she was, if I talk about his famous work is Vishwambhara. Okay, Vishwambhara is his famous work. So that you can also remember from the perspective of books and authors. Now, guys, coming to this thing, defense exercises are always important. So question I'm asking you is on exercise Winbacks 2022 has recently taken place at Chandi Mandir. So important for us is this place, where it has taken place, the name of the exercise that has taken place. Now, this common question that could be asked is, this exercise is conducted between which two countries? So it is conducted between India and along with which of the following country? I think this is a really easy question to answer. Okay? So answer kya hai yahan pe? Option number is Vietnam. So India-Vietnam exercise name is Winbacks. So I have discussed with you. The next question can be formed is kahan pe hui hai? Where it has taken place? So it has taken place at Chandi Mandir. Now guys, this was CNN News. Take on 31st of July. As I have discussed with you, joint exercise has commenced at Chandi Mandir. Next is guys, the next question is Ainija. Ainija is an exercise of India between India and which of the following country? You have to tell me. It has taken place in Rajasthan. So it is scheduled. Okay? It is scheduled, that is from 1st to 13th of August. This Ainija exercise will basically take place. So you have to tell me where this exercise, it is the exercise between which of the following countries who are participating along with India. The answer here is Oman. Oman is the answer here. So Oman, India, you should remember it is Ainija is the important thing that needs to be remembered here. Where it is taking place? It is taking place in Rajasthan, the second important thing for us. So I have discussed places Rajasthan, previous edition was organized at Muscat. Okay, so this was all about the phase 1 questions, the questions that are relevant only for the phase 1. Now guys, let's discuss the questions that are equally relevant for both phase 1 and phase 2. Now guys, the first question I am asking you is on a scheme that is Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. We have learnt about the scheme a lot of time. We have revised the scheme a lot of time. But still, there are some things which are updated on a PIB basis regarding some specific schemes. So there was a detailed article on the enrollments on the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana that was being seen on 31st of August. Ticket. That is just a day before. So while I was reading the article, there are a lot of things that needs to, that if you are very thorough with the scheme, these are the questions that are being formed. When we would say these are very difficult questions. So this will help us revising this question. The question that I am asking on the Matru Vandana Yojana, first question I am asking is which of the following statements are incorrect about the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. The first statement I am asking you is it is a component under the sub-scheme Samrathya of Mission Shakti. Samrathya under Mission Shakti, whether this you know or not, it is a sub-scheme under Mission Shakti, but under which component, Samrathya or another, that is important to remember. Second question is, it aims to promote, the basically thing is that there are subsidy money is being provided to the pregnant and lactating mother for the birth of child. It says that for positive behavioral changes, the money, that is the amount is also provided at the, incentive is also provided at the birth of second child. If that girl, if that child is a girl, whether that statement is right, whether money is provided for second child or not, this is to remember for us. Okay? Then I talk about the third statement here. The beneficiary's husband's Aadhaar is mandatory for availing the benefits under the scheme. Okay? So now guys, in my opinion, what I would like to you is, just pause here, try to solve the question because you have read this scheme a lot of time. Try to solve the question here, whether you know this question or not. If you do not know that, tell me honestly in the comment box, sir. It was difficult question to attempt. That is question number 6. It was really difficult to attempt. Okay. So tell me honestly. Okay. So now if I talk about these kind of questions, the important thing are again the keywords that we have highlighted here. Now telling the answer here, guys, answer here is option number C. That is only third statement here becomes incorrect. Rest all are correct. Only third becomes incorrect because the beneficiary's husband's Aadhaar card is not mandatory. Beneficiary's Aadhaar card is mandatory. That is pregnant and lactating mothers. Aadhaar card is mandatory under the scheme, but her husband's Aadhaar card is not mandatory. That is one point to remember. Yes, that is absolutely right. Generally, the incentive that is being provided under this scheme is provided in two installments. That is, the 5,000 rupees is being provided in two installments. But the important thing here is for one child, but the important is if the second child, to promote the sex ratio, to increase the sex ratio among the girls, okay, and to incentivize the girl birth, this scheme says that if the second child is a girl, yes, then an incentive of rupees 5,000 will also be provided on the second child also. Remember one thing, this is the keyword here. If that child is girl, then only the beneficiary will be getting an amount of rupees 5,000. That is an incentive of 5,000 on the birth of second child also. Now, the third statement I've explained to you, that Aadhaar is not mandatory for the person. And that is again right. It is a component of the sub scheme under the, it is a sub scheme under Mission Shakti, but it is working as a sub scheme under the Samarthya component of the Mission Shakti. Now let's discuss the next question again on this specific scheme. This is again, if I say these are not that much easy questions to attempt. Again, I will say pause here, look at the questions, then try to solve it on yourself whether you remember this, whether you have covered this scheme in depth or not. Because guys, on the 1st of April, there were some amendments that have been changed on this specific scheme. Now the question I'm asking you is, which statements are correct with respect to the scheme? For the maternity benefit component, the amount is basically transferred to the escrow account of the states or UTs. Now this is something difficult, it's not that much easy, so you have to remember about where the funding is basically being provided. Then if I talk about early registration of pregnancy, is basically being termed as a registration of pregnancy within 150 days from the date of her last menstruation period, or the records are being made on the MCP card, TKG. Then the next is, eligible beneficiary can apply at any point of time but not later than 730 days. So these are kind of questions that you generally see in phase 2 of the examination, because here the examiner goes really really into depth of the scheme. And these are the kind of questions, because I have handpicked each and every point just from the PIB. And this has been observed by us guys. The questions that are really difficult to attempt in the examinations are generally being the statements that are being given in PIB. So coming back to this question guys, here option number D, that is all these statements are correct. Yes, for the maternity benefit component, the money is provided to the escrow account of the state or UTs, but for other components it is being transferred to the treasury account of states and UTs. Yes, that is again a right. Second statement is again right, guys. When we talk about the early registration period, it is basically termed as a period that is 150 days from the last date of the period, last menstrual period, or the data or the record that has been mentioned in the MCP card. Again, for eligible beneficiary, he can apply for availing the incentives, ticket, but not later than 730 days of the pregnancy. That is something that is important for you to remember in this specific scheme. Now coming about the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana, we know it was launched in 2017, centrally sponsored scheme hai, okay? It is a component under the sub scheme, Samarthya of under the Mission Shakti scheme, okay? When I talk about the scheme, basically partial compensation, so it means you will be incentivized, but in some ways. So when I talk about here, that under how many installments the money will be provided, earlier it used to be 3 installments, but guys, when the scheme was amended or when it was modified in April 2022, it has been said that now the money will be provided in 2 installments. 2 installments, the money will be provided. Earlier it used to be 3 installments, but now it is 2 installments. Then the purpose I will talk about, second important, health seeking behavior of the pregnant woman and lactating mothers. Now guys, the things that I was discussing with you, what are the changes that have been made on from 1st of April 2022 onwards. That's why this becomes important, because this scheme is being seen in news here also. Now if I talk about C, maternity benefits are provided to socially and economically disadvantaged sections of the society also. Then maternity benefit for first two living children will be provided if the second child is a girl. That is important to remember. Normal cases only for the first child the benefits are provided, but here the modification was made on 1st of April that if the second child is a girl, then yes, the incentive will be provided for the second child also. Now, the third important thing that I was discussing, 5000 rupees in two installments will be provided. Now, guys, here generally the students got confused there that how much is the benefit provided under the Matru Vandana Yojana? Is it 5000, 6000? So, financial assistance of 5000 is provided under the Matru Vandana Yojana, but the beneficiary can also avail the benefit under the Janani Suraksha Yojana also. Remember this thing. Maternity benefit can also be availed under the Janani Suraksha Yojana, which is amounting to rupees 6000. So remember these 2 points very, very carefully, because it used to be very easy. You can pause the video and try to again listen to the things, because these are the two very prominent things that needs to be covered, guys. Maternity benefit under the Matru Vandana Yojana, two installments, 5000 rupees, that is financial assistance of 5000 is provided in two installments for first child. If the second child is girl, then only for second child also 5000 rupees will be provided. The second important thing is, under the Janani Suraksha Yojana, the maternity benefits of rupees 6000 rupees can be availed by the beneficiary. This is something important that needs to be remembered. Now, when I talk about for the second child, the benefit of 6000 will be provided in one installment. That is important. For the second child, 6000 rupees will be provided in a single installment. That is important to remember. Okay, then if, that I have discussed, husband Aadhaar is not mandatory. In case of miscarriage or stillbirth, it says the next maternity or the next pregnancy will be considered as a fresh case. This is something that is important for the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. Talk about other key benefits of the scheme, guys. So cash incentive of rupees 5000 I've discussed will be provided, will be given, and the amount will be transferred in the post office account or to the bank account of the beneficiary. One point to remember, because the examiner can write it will be given in the form of cash, that is wrong. The amount is given directly into the bank accounts. Then mother and child protection card is basically being made, that is MCP card, which is the verification tool to verify whether that beneficiary is being eligible to get the incentive or not. For that, this card is mandatory. Then early registration, I've discussed with you, 150 days. Okay, all pregnant women who have registered before 1st of Jan 2017 are eligible. Okay, sorry, after that is eligible. Then if I talk about the beneficiaries, if anybody has any twins, triplet or quadruplet, it's not that the money will be provided for all this. They will be considered as only a single child, that is the first living child. That is the benefit will be provided only for a single child here. That is again important here. Eligible beneficiaries can apply within 730 days. Grants in aid will be provided. Okay, as I have discussed, escrow accounts and trainee accounts. So, escrow account mein kya hoga? Aapke maternity benefit components will be transferred to the escrow account, and the rest money will be given to the, as I've discussed, to the state's treasury account. So these are the important things that you should be able to understand about the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana also. A very, very important thing for our examination. Now, guys, coming to the next important question, that is on the next scheme, that is revamped distribution sector scheme. So recently, the Prime Minister has participated in the culmination of Ujjwal Bharat, Ujjwala Bhavishya Power at 2047 conclave. So here he has discussed about the scheme. I am asking you, what is the tenure of this revamped distribution public sector scheme? The answer here is, that is option number D, financial year 2021 to financial year 2025 is the right answer here. Then if I talk about, it was seen on 30th July when the Prime Minister has launched this power sector. It is not a new scheme. It is an old scheme. It was launched earlier also. But still in the PIB it has been mentioned that Prime Minister has focused more on this specific scheme. That's why this scheme becomes really, really important for our examination. Now, when I talk about the specific news, guys, as we know, the tenure of the scheme is, that is from period of 5 years, that is from 2021-22 to 2025-26 is the answer here. Then, coming to the next question on the scheme is, which statements are correct with respect to the scheme? It is an initiative of Ministry of Power. The scheme has a total outlay of over rupees 2 lakh crores. The purpose of the scheme is basically to provide financial assistance to DISCOMs for modernization and strengthening of the distribution infrastructure. That is, quality of supply will be provided, has to be provided to the end customers. So which statements are correct here? If I say, so guys, option number B, only 1 and 3 becomes correct here. Now let's discuss about this scheme, why that statement is incorrect, because total outlay kitna hai, 2 lakh nahi hai, it is 3 lakh crores. That's why your second statement becomes incorrect here, theek hai? Rest you can have a look out the scheme, theek hai? It is a scheme of Ministry of Power, theek hai? And the purpose here is basically assistance is provided so that quality could be done better and modernization could be done for the power infrastructure in the country. Then guys, the next question again on the scheme is, the revamped distribution sector scheme, it aims to reduce the aggregate technical and commercial losses to the pan India level up to dash percentage and the average cost of supply average revenue realized gap to zero by how much, by which year? What is the target year here? So here I am question asking you a question on the targets here that is related to this specific scheme. The answer here is, guys, that is option number C, 12 to 15% is the target. That is, the reduction is of aggregate technical and commercial is to reduce it to 12 to 15%, and the average cost of supply average revenue should be realized to zero by 2024-25. That's the answer for this specific scheme. So here you can have a look at this specific thing. So guys, this was all about your PIB session for the day. We have discussed two very important schemes that were being seen in news. So we have always observed the schemes that are being recently seen in news are very, very important for your examination. So we have tried to cover that thing also, plus the other important components that are really, really important for your phase one examinations. Hope you have liked the session, guys. If you have liked the sessions, kindly subscribe the channel, then also share the video with your friends also so that they can also get the benefit. And to get the access of the PDF, guys, kindly subscribe to the Telegram channel, the link for which is given in the description below. Now a very important announcement for all of you guys. So we are running the flat 40% off plus an additional 10% off on all our NABARD courses. So NABARD examination is coming on, so you can avail all these courses of NABARD by using the code NABARD, which is validated till 3rd of August. So I will not say to wait till 3rd of August, guys. Jaldi jaldi avail kar lijiye, theek hai? Avail this discount as early as you can. So this is a very important NABARD sale, guys. You can avail the benefit of our course by using the code that is NABARD. So guys, this was all about the session. If you guys want any specific topic that you want me to cover in the next lecture, guys, kindly comment that specific topic. I will be trying to bring up the next video on that specific videos on that specific topic that you guys want a video on that. Okay. Plus, if you guys kindly try to work on that. If you guys have any kind of doubt, you could drop me an email at hello@avtar.co.in. You could even place us a call at this number, that is 81462-0724-1. So I hope, guys, the lecture is fruitful for you. Keep learning, keep preparing hard, and keep working. I hope you will succeed. So wishing you all the best for your examinations. Bye-bye.